My god, Dragon Ball Super just keeps surprising us more and more. But welcome back everyone, and today I'll be reviewing F22, the latest ep on Dragon Ball Super. Boy, this episode is really crazy and intense. A bag of stuff occurred. Music to Super has pretty much grown up. Chat music. Yeah, I don't mind it at all one bit. And the animation for this episode was quite good. Yes. So anyway, we'll pick things up with Tagoma, powering up, ready to take on the five warriors all at once, boasting that how he suffered and trained Frieza for 4 months that gave him a body of steel enough to pretty much penetrate. And so Piccolo steps up onto the fray and he powers up and charges at Tagoma. Fools on wax. To no avail, just it was nothing. He just took it really like he had a body head of steel. Grabs Piccolo's arm, and this is like a throwback to back on Namek when Nail was back to challenge Frieza. And Frieza grabs his arm, in this case Tagoma grabs Piccolo's arm, snaps it right off. Yeah, and then he pounds Piccolo, he's just hitting him, full on whacking on. And then Gohan, he steps into the fray, and he fires a blast that sends Tagoma flying back. So it gives Piccolo a chance to recover, so he regenerates his arm, because Meki and thank God for him. And Gohan tells him he needs a Senzu Beam. He's gonna step up to the fray. And he's ready to take on Tagoma. And then the other fighters, they all get up. They're ready to face Tagoma. Gohan just, that blast nothing to him, yeah. And from out of nowhere, all of a sudden, of course, we've seen this in the previous episode, when Goten Trunks has sent the high spike to Gohan's power and charge. And they're already fused as Goten's, in fact they're Super Saiyans. You can charge him, and what they do, they just knock Tagoma right into Kabonga. So Tagoma's like, full-on whack pretty much causes more damage to anyone, because of course naturally if you get nutted it would be painful beyond belief no matter how strong you supposedly are, yeah? So Master Roshi pretty much goes off. Decent move but not weak at all. So Tagoma's on the ground, eye-kneeling pain, whatnot. And then just Gotenks just fused straight away after the. I don't know, because usually with the fusion, Metamorphosis fusion is supposed to last 30 minutes. Yeah? And the amount of time it takes them to go around the world to stay in Dragon Ball Z. Go 3 times around the world in less minute, if memory serves me correctly. So I don't know. If they're one of those plot holes, you know, people don't remember, they don't get the facts straight. Anyway, so they're confused, and Frieza's like, so it's a fusion of some sort. Let me see. He recognizes Kakarot Goat. His son! And then he looked at Trunks. And he, like, vaguely seems familiar to the one who sliced him in half. Of course, that was Future Trunks. And he's saying what to do. He's just getting all roused up. And you know, instead of hitting face with them full on, And here it comes to play. He knew as a frog he comes to the goal. And oh my god. I don't know if he's had this power all along, but he's just done a hole. But he writes onto the dirt. Yes, this alien like of man. Yeah. is a gets a flashback to a bit of PTSD. Frieza has like traumatic stress disorder, and remembers Kakarot has tries to spare Frieza's life, Frieza got sliced in half.
Play another with me, yeah. He wants to fight them again, of course. He was lucky.
stark, or I think it's in that place, so maybe in order to escape, they could just touch on the stuff any time and then they're teleported back. Yeah, so I think that's pretty much the end of this episode. So, spoilers everyone, next week, yeah, shit really goes down. I think we received one of the message, yeah, probably from Horrible Fish, yeah, or that we were late for this message. Yeah, all this is the Captain Moth. Wait. If I make it to Earth, showdown between Kakarot and Frieza finally begins. Yeah, we're gonna go into the meat of the story now. Oh, now, Vegeta, I don't know if he's gonna go, if he's gonna kill Frieza in the end or what, or, but it seems like Vegeta will be the one to take on Ginyu. And perhaps he'll finish the job, you know, that he left on Namek, so he'll be the one to finally permanently put Ginyu in his place, you know? Because of course Vegeta, even though he's a good guy, he's a hero now, he's a protagonist, he's still not soft-hearted, he's not as forgiving as Kakarot, obviously he's not. For good reason to touch, you know? Yes, Kakarot obviously can learn a few things or two. So yes, of course, Vegeta will put Captain Ginyu in his place to go on his body or not.